Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain basic pulse shaping techniques. So here I'll discuss three basic pulse shaping techniques. One is unipolar, second is polar, and third is bipolar. There are so many other pulse shaping techniques even which is available. But these are three basic pulse shaping techniques. That is what generally we use it in digital communication that I'll be discussing in this session. And this is what I am continuing from my previous session where I have explained line coding techniques. So let us begin this session with first point, that is unipolar. So when we talk about unipolar pulse shaping techniques, then usually what we do is we assign voltage level with respect to bits. So when you have bits 1 and 0, then 1 is assigned with voltage which is what, plus A, and 0 that is assigned with voltage that is 0. This plus A voltage could be plus 1 voltage, it could be plus 2 voltage, it could be plus 5 voltage, it could be plus 20 voltage, and 0 that is assigned with 0 voltage. So that is what the case which we do in terms of voltage assigning in unipolar technique. When we talk about polar, when we talk about polar pulse shaping technique, then in that all we do is we assign bits with voltage levels as per 1 and 0, where 1 is assigned with plus A voltage, and 0 that is assigned with minus A voltage. So that is what the case that we do in case of polar. Now third basic technique that we use is bipolar technique. So in bipolar pulse shaping technique, all we do is we assign bits with voltage levels where 1 is assigned with plus A and minus A voltage, and 0 is assigned with 0 voltage. So basically, if you observe here, there are basically three different voltage levels, plus A, minus A, and 0. So because of three different amplitude level that is assigned with bipolar, it is even referred as pseudo ternary codes. So there are three amplitudes in bipolar. So it is even referred as pseudo ternary code. Ternary means three. So here we are assigning three voltage with voltages in terms of zeros and ones. That's why it is referred as pseudo ternary code. Now here one more thing that we need to understand, this plus A and minus A, that is what we assigned alternatively. So let us try to understand this with respect to one example. So let us take one example of bipolar so it will be more clear. Now see here, as if we send 111, 1, 1 and 1. And this is what the waveform that we generate over here with respect to time, and here there is amplitude. Let us say this is plus A voltage, let us say this is minus A voltage. So when we send signal by using bipolar, first one that is assigned with plus A voltage. But when it comes to next one, at that time this voltage will get alternate. So next one will be assigned with voltage that is minus A voltage. And when it comes to next one, it will be assigned with again plus A voltage. So ultimately, one thing that we can understand here, we need to have a memory of 1 bit where it needs to remember a voltage which was there with previous one. So here these ones that is assigned with plus A and minus A voltage alternatively. So here bit 1 is marked as plus A and minus A alternatively. So this method of bipolar is even referred as alternate marked inversion. So this method of bipolar is referred as alternate marked inversion. So that is, in short, we referred it as AMI code. So this is what basic pulse shaping techniques that we use in digital communication. And in future I'll explain methods with respect to these three. So one should remember these three pulse shaping techniques first. In unipolar, bit 1 is assigned with plus A voltage, bit 0 is assigned with 0 voltage. In polar, bit 1 is assigned with plus A voltage, bit 0 is assigned with minus A voltage. But in bipolar, bit 1 is assigned with plus A or minus A voltage, and bit 0 is assigned with 0 voltage. So there are three different levels. So even this is even referred as pseudo ternary code. And here ones are assigned with plus A and minus A voltage, and that is what we assigned alternatively. If first one that is assigned with plus A voltage, the next one will assign, next one that will be getting assigned with minus A voltage. So definitely next one that will, that should be assigned with plus A voltage. So ultimately this is what alternate marked inversion code, where this bipolar code needs to have 1 bit memory where it needs to remember a voltage of previous one so that it can assign voltage to next one. So in bipolar technique, there is a 1 bit memory which will store data of previous one so that it can assign voltage in next one. So that is what the basics which is there with pulse shaping techniques, with unipolar, polar and bipolar techniques. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, I'll make videos in future. And in next session, I'll be going to explain you three basic techniques, which is what we usually utilized in digital communication as not return to zero, return to zero and Manchester coding. And those three techniques could be utilized with these three basic pulse shaping techniques. So that is what I'll be going to explain in next session. So next session will be with RZ, NRZ, Manchester code, by unipolar, polar and bipolar. So how to assign RZ, NRZ and Manchester with unipolar, polar and bipolar. So that is what I'll be going to explain in next session. So stay tuned with this channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. And I have seen so many comments of students. I'm sorry if I cannot reply to all questions. The reason is all I am finding is daily there are about 70-80 questions that is coming from students. So it is almost next to impossible to reply to all the questions asked by students. But probably I will try my level best to solve your queries by placing videos. The reason is there are some questions which is common. So I can solve it by placing videos here. Thank you so much for watching this video.